Local athletes and an honor student could spend the next year behind bars.
Today, three Lakota West students owned up to some very serious crimes, including burglary and stealing guns, as well as a car. WLWT News Source Karen Johnson was the only reporter in court today as these teenagers admitted they did it. She's live in Westchester with the details. Karen.
And guys, we're not identifying the Lakota students because of their ages, but I can tell you it's been quite a shock to folks here at West, teachers who know the teenagers. Out of character is the way one describes it. A Lakota senior, an athlete in his junior year, and an honor student. Together today, not in class, but in court.
Plead true, Your Honor.
Pleading guilty to crimes, felonies committed during winter break. All three spent Christmas behind bars. Two admitted to burglarizing a home on Overglen Drive. Police say they stole handguns, rifles, shotguns, electronics, jewelry, Louis Vuitton handbags, and even an Audi.
The young man whom I represent has never been in trouble before and is an honor student and is deeply upset that he found himself in court today and upset for the ordeal that the victims have gone through.
That teen admitted to hanging out with the other two after the burglary. When he dropped the others off at the stolen Audi, cops were waiting. One of the guns was later found in the honor student's car, leading him to plead to attempting to receive stolen property.
He thought that was best for everyone involved to take responsibility and face the consequences.
Attorneys say two of the three teens have never been in trouble with the law before. The motive still unclear. But those who know the students who did appear uncomfortable in court today told me off camera they're good kids who made poor decisions. And I did speak with the victims today off camera. They didn't want to go on camera, but did tell me they don't know the Lakota students. They don't know why their house was targeted. The district, by the way, here declined any comment. Reporting live tonight in Westchester, Karen Johnson, WLWT News 5.
Now, the two boys who pleaded guilty to burglary face a minimum of 1 year in juvenile detention, a maximum of until they turn 21. The third could get lesser time. They're going to be sentenced on February 7th.